Hey, Desmond Child's got a brand new album out. Legendary songwriter, producer, Desmond Child. It's called Desmond Child Live, available now wherever music is sold.
If you look at my career, I mean, if I had stayed being an artist, I would never have achieved what I achieved by, you know, spreading the wealth around, you know, right, with between all the artists that I've worked with. I've all told, I've sold over 500 million records, and not any single one of my artists that I worked with, you know, has done that individually.
Right. Now, see, it's funny you say that, because, you know, 500 million records just to you alone versus the artists. I mean, does it? And especially because now you're going out and doing the songs live. Like, was there ever that itch, like even back in the day, like, damn, you know, I'm writing all these fucking hits. Like, why ain't I on stage doing these songs? Like, were you content with being the studio guy, like behind the scenes, or was like deep down where you're like, damn, I should be out there doing these songs? Or at least, like, did you ever want to be like a member of Bon Jovi? Like, you should be up there belting out Living on a Prayer, you know?
Well, I guess I, you know, I've always wanted to be a star. So, you know, I tried several times and I wasn't successful. So I had an album out in 91 called Discipline. And, you know, I sold like, you know, 250,000 copies, and that wasn't good enough for the label. You know, they were used to selling millions, you know, per artist. But, you know, then times changed. And so now, like, a song of mine that I co-wrote with John Bon Jovi and Richie Sambora, Living on a Prayer, last year got 500 million streams. And, you know, that's like fantastic.
What's the revenue like versus, you know, when you were selling records to streaming? I'm sure it's like it's completely non-existent.
Well, true. But those 500 million streams, that my share, my third share, added up to $6,000.
$6,000.
Mm-hmm.
How is that even possible?
Well, you know, I think songwriters kind of lost the ball when they first started figuring out who gets what at the beginning of all this.
Right.
Because the, you know, the audio part, you know, their take is 16 times more than us, but it's still low for them too.
Yeah.
And so then last year, all of us banded together, and we got an amazing thing through Congress called the Music Modernization Act, which is going to help to raise the rates. And in this very divided world, we had both parties completely unanimous, no dissenters, of the Congress and the Senate. And it got all the way to the president, and he signed it. So now, within the next 4 to 5, 6 years, the rates are going to start to lift a little bit and give people relief, because it doesn't make sense to be a professional songwriter anymore. So we're losing a lot of talent.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you can't make a living. You can't even pay your rent on, you know, and especially with a massive hit like Living on a Prayer, for your cut to be just 6 G's out of how many streams did you say it was?
500 million.
Like 500 million. I mean, it's ridiculous. I mean, just think about like a songwriter in his apartment in like New York City, like just playing the coffee shop and releasing a couple of singles here and there. Like it's impossible.
Well, you know, it's a nickel and dime business. What can I tell you?
Yeah, well, that's it. Well, compared to streaming and, you know, records back in the day, like, do you think it was because they didn't think or they didn't see where the technology was going to go? And, you know, what do you think they didn't perceive streaming to be, I guess, having the music out there? Do you think that maybe they just thought people were just going to buy records? And
I don't know what they thought. I think initially everyone thought, well, you know, it'll help to sell the actual record. But then when that stopped and, you know, you yeah, can't even buy a CD player, it's like, what?
Yeah.
You know, so it really backfired. Whatever the machinations were at that time, you know, has left a lot of us in the dust.
Yeah.
You know, so, you know, the thing is that, you know, you just, if you love music, you know, there's no B plan. You just keep going.